sitting here with women's basketball coach Tim Curry, fresh off a 78-62 win over Point Georgia. You know, it was a little bit of a slow first half, really come out rolling in the second half. Talk a bit about the game tonight.
Well, I mean, you know, I was afraid of a letdown after our game on Saturday. Not sure how that happens when you're playing somebody that is only two games behind you in the conference and has already beaten you this year. But what I was afraid of occurred. The first 8.5 minutes of the game, we were not good defensively. We were not good offensively. And was down and got ourselves in a 10-point hole. But fortunately, we did rebound a little bit to get ourselves back in the lead at the half. And in the second half, did the things that we needed to do the entire game.
You know, obviously in the first half, Haley had a little bit of a rough go offensively. Lydia picked that up and ended up with, you know, 20 points tonight. Talk a bit about, you know, Perkins, you know, feeding the ball to Lydia throughout the game.
Well, I mean, early it wasn't as much of a struggle for us to make shots as it was we couldn't take care of the basketball. Our guards couldn't take care of the ball. We had unforced turnovers, dropping the ball out of bounds. When nobody's guarding us, just losing the basketball, throwing it away. So we weren't getting a lot of shots. Plus, we were settling at times for threes. They don't have a lot of size. And you've got to attack them to the lane because of that. And if they're going to double, if they do, then you got wide open threes off the kick. And if they don't, then you go score in the lane. It just took taking care of the basketball and understanding what our strengths was in order to get it turned around offensively.
When you look at the box score, you see 10 assists from Nate White, but then you also see those 8 turnovers out. I mean, that's obviously a freshman.
Yeah, well, I mean, she had 5 in the first 6 minutes of the game. You know, just and she did that against Tennessee Wesleyan on Saturday. You know, she came out and turned over 3 of the first 4 times down the floor. It's just a freshman, one, gaining the confidence that, hey, I'm a point guard and I've got to take control of my team from the get-go. She's a freshman, so she kind of defers a little bit at times. And in our system, so much pressure is put on the point guard to create things for us offensively, as it always has been. Once she ever understands that with her quickness, that kid's going to be a special player. But and she's had 2 great second halves in a row in games. We just got her to bring that at the beginning, that mentality and that attitude at the beginning of the game rather than waiting until the second half.
Yeah, Haley Perkins, 19 points, 11 rebounds. I think that's her 6th double-double in the season. Talk about what she means as a leader on the floor, because you hate to have her out, but she's got to have a break at times.
Well, she's that kid, too, that, like I said, keeping her out of foul trouble is the big thing. And in the first half, we've had that happen several times, that she ends up with a foul that she creates because, you know, Tiggers have got to bounce, and that's what we call her as a nickname sometimes, because Tiggers have got to jump in the air and get beat off the dribble and then foul somebody. But she always picks up one of those fouls in the first half and has to go to the bench because she's trying to help a teammate who got beat. If we can do a better job around her, because she is a kid that is going to help. She's going to try to make a play for you on both ends of the floor. And we're a much better team when she's playing 30 minutes a game than we are when she's playing 10, because at point she played 10 minutes and 57 seconds. You know, tonight in the basketball game, I think she ended up playing 30 minutes and 39 seconds. So keeping her on the floor is, without question, a big key.
And, you know, Desiree Owens had 26 points tonight for Point. It's pretty much their offense runs through her. I think, you know, you see 26 points, but he did a pretty good job limiting her.
Well,
could have done a lot more.
We didn't in the first 8.5 minutes because she had, you know, she had 12 of their first 15. And was making mistakes and things that we had talked about in pregame, you know, overreacting to a fake and her shooting a 3, not rotating from the backside and taking the charge and letting her get to the rim, you know, those things. But once we kind of understood that, and she is a tremendous offensive player. I mean, she scores against everybody. But you've got to contain her and make her take tough shots, because if you give her good ones, she's going to make them.
Yeah, obviously, picked up another big win in the conference. Where do you feel like this team's at right now?
Well, I told our team all year long, I feel like I've got 2 different teams. I've got the team that is really, really good. And then I've got the team that I don't like very much because we don't do anything well. You know, and we've not yet understood that you got to have your really good moments, but you got to live in the area of just being solid. And we've yet to figure that out, and that's something over the next 3 weeks going into tournament play that we're going to have to be able to do, because you got to win in the tournament by being solid more than you're great, and you definitely can't have those bad moments.
Got another tough road matchup going to Columbia on Saturday. Those fighting koalas, they fight with you on the road.
Well, it's a tough place to play. We've got sport court floor, which is something you want to play on one time a year. It's a long trip. You know, and they're a very athletic, very big, very aggressive basketball team that can cause you a lot of problems with their athletes and their depth and their size. So we have to be very, very focused, or you can go down there and put yourself in a tough situation in a hurry trying to dig out of it.
All right, the women's basketball team will be back home next Wednesday against St. Andrews at 5 o'clock. Thanks, Tim.
Thank you much.